Once again, guys, refer to the specs. I have the link below. So based on the data, we're supposed to create 5 holes right here, okay, on the belt strap. And the dimension of the hole is 1 centimeter, okay? So to do that, I'm going to come over here to this internal line tool, click on it, then hover the mouse to the right, and then select internal ellipse, okay? Then I'm going to come over here. Let me zoom in a little more. Once again, place your 2 fingers onto the mouse pad and slide forward to zoom in, okay? All right, so as you can see, when I hover the mouse over that baseline right there, the guy appeared. It showed that we are right on the center on that line, and that's what we want. So I'm going to click 1 on that line, okay? Just left click 1 to bring this create ellipse window. Let me move it to the left. Okay, by default, diameter is checked. And we want to change the width of 1 centimeter. And as you can see, when I insert the value for the width, the height also changed. This because this link icon is checked. If you only want to change just the width and not the height, you just uncheck that. You see how you click one, it kind of link, and click another time, it doesn't link. So I will show you the next one when we want to have these values differences, okay? For now, I'm going to just check on that link right there. And I'm going to come down here to replicate. And the interval, I want to change it to 3 centimeter. And number of shape, I want to change that to 5. And as you can see, the preview over here, we just create the perfect circle that have perfect length from one to the next. After that, I'm going to click on OK. All right, let me zoom back out a little bit. Place your 2 fingers onto the mouse pad and slide backward to zoom out, okay? Right there. And I'm going to pan it to the left, press down Option Alt, left click. Next, I'm going to cut and sew these circle shape to create the holes onto the belt strap, okay? So I'm going to come over here to the Transform Pattern tool, click on it. Then I'm going to just my key select all these circle shapes, then right click, and come down here to cut and sew, click on it. So we just cut and sew this circle shape into a hole onto the belt strap. After that, I'm going to move the circle shape up here, okay? To do that, while the Transform Pattern tool is active, I'm going to click 1 on the first circle, then press down Shift, and then continue clicking all that circle right there. Then I'm going to release the Shift on the keyboard, and then left click and drag to above it, okay? So while the circle are selected, I'm going to right click, and I want to offset as internal line, okay? So right here, offset as internal line, click on it. And this time I'm going to type in for the distance of 0.2, okay? Number of offsets is 1, perfect. And once again, guys, as you can see, in this preview, we see the circle create the internal lines in it. That's what we want, and I'm going to click on OK. So by default, these circle shape into that circle as selected. I'm going to right click, okay? And I'm going to come over here to cut and sew one more time. Okay. So as you can see, we just create this perfect eyelet shape for a belt strap, okay? So next, I'm going to click 1 on the page to get out of this selection. After that, I'm going to come over here to this object browser, and I'm going to name this fabric number 1 to strap, okay? And press return enter on the keyboard to confirm. After that, I'm going to come over here to add, click on it. I want to create one more fabric. So once again, click on the add button to add another fabric. And I'm going to name this fabric eyelet. Press return and enter on the keyboard to confirm. And I'm going to come over here on this fabric once again and then change the name to circle. Okay, I'm going to press return or enter on the keyboard to confirm. After that, I'm going to just marquee select that circle right there. Then press down shift on the keyboard and then select the next circle. The next circle. The next circle. And then I'm going to come over here to the circle fabric and click on the twirling arrow right there. Because we want to apply that circle fabric onto all the circle, okay? So let me click on that fabric. So as you can see, when I click on that circle fabric, all the circle highlighted in yellow. That means all the circle right here has this circle fabric in it, okay? Next, I'm going to do the same with the eyelet. I'm going to come over here and my key select just the eyelet this time and press down shift on my keyboard and then my key select all the eyelets, okay? Okay, then I'm going to come over here to this eyelet fabric and to the right there, the twirling arrow, click on it, okay? So once again, I'm going to click on that fabric and as you can see, all these eyelets are highlighted in yellow. So next, I'm going to apply the taping onto this hole as well as the eyelet. To do that, I'm going to just my key select this right there, that eyelet, press down shift on my keyboard, and then continue selecting that eyelet. Then I'm going to come over here to this property editor and scroll down here to under selected line and come to the seam taping. I'm going to check that to turn it on, okay? Next, I'm going to do the same right here. Click on the first hole and then press down shift on the keyboard, continue clicking. Then I'm going to come down here and apply seam taping to the holes. So after that, I'm going to continue working on to the head of the belt strap.
Hi, I'm Rose Willie from Encoder Fashion. There is more information under this video. Bye!